Tuesday, 1st October. Welcome to evening prayer. I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Hear us, O Lord, for your mercy is great. We will exalt you, O God our Saviour, and praise your name forever and ever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. O gracious light, pure brightness of the everlasting Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, our eyes behold the Vesper light. We sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Grant, merciful Lord, to your faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins and serve you with a quiet mind. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 94. O Lord God of vengeance, O God of vengeance, show yourself. Rise up, O Judge of the world. Give the arrogant their deserts. How long shall the wicked, O Lord, how long shall the wicked triumph? They bluster in their insolence. All evildoers are full of boasting. They crush your people, O Lord, and afflict your chosen nation. They murder the widow and the stranger, and put the orphans to death. Yet they say, the Lord does not see. The God of Jacob takes no notice. Consider well, you dullards among the people. When will you fools understand? He that planted the ear, does not he hear? He that formed the eyes, does he not see? He who admonishes the nations, will he not punish? He who teaches all the world, has he no knowledge? The Lord knows all human thoughts, how like a puff of wind they are. Happy are they whom you instruct, O Lord, whom you teach out of your law, to give them rest in evil days, until a pit is dug for the wicked. For the Lord will not abandon his people, nor will he forsake his own. For judgment will again be just, and all the true of heart would follow it. Who rose up for me against the wicked? Who took my part against evildoers? If the Lord had not come to my help, I should soon have dwelt in the land of silence. As often as I have said, my foot has slipped, your love, O Lord, upheld me. When many cares fill my mind, your consolations cheer my soul. Can a corrupt tribunal have any part with you, one which frames evil into law? They conspire against the life of the just, and condemn the innocent to death. But the Lord has become my stronghold, and my God the rock of my trust. He will turn their wickedness back upon them, and destroy them in their own malice. The Lord our God will destroy them. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The first reading, a reading from the word of the Lord written in 2 Chronicles chapter 29, verses 1 to 3, chapter 30, verse 1, and 10 to 27. Hezekiah began to reign when he was 25 years old. He reigned 29 years in Jerusalem. His mother was Abijah, daughter of Zechariah. He did what was right in the sight of the Lord, just as his ancestor David had done. In the first year of his reign, in the first month, he opened the doors of the house of the Lord and repaired them. Hezekiah sent word to all of Israel and Judah, and wrote letters also to Ephraim and Manasseh. that they should come to the house of the Lord at Jerusalem to keep the Passover the Lord, the God of Israel. So the couriers went from city to city through the country of Ephraim and Manasseh and as far as Zebulun, but they laughed them to scorn and mocked them. Only a few of Asher, Manasseh, and Zebulun humbled themselves and came to Jerusalem. The hand of God was also on Judah, to give them one heart to do what the king and the officials commanded by the word of the Lord. Many people came together in Jerusalem to keep the festival of the unleavened bread in the second month, a very large assembly. They set to work and removed the altars that were in Jerusalem, and all the altars for offering incense they took away and threw into Wadi Kidron. They slaughtered the Passover lamb on the 14th day of the second month. The priests and the Levites were ashamed, and they sanctified themselves and brought burnt offerings into the house of the Lord. They took their accustomed posts, according to the law of Moses, the man of God. The priests dashed the blood that they received from the hands of the Levites, for there were many in the assembly who had not sanctified themselves. Therefore, the Levites had to slaughter the Passover lamb for everyone who was not clean to make it holy to the Lord. For a multitude of the people, many of them from Ephraim, Manasseh, Issachar, and Zebulun, had not cleansed themselves. Yet they ate the Passover contrary to what was prescribed. But Hezekiah prayed for them, saying, "May the good Lord pardon all who set their hearts to seek God, the Lord, the God of the ancestors, even though not in the accordance with the sanctuary rules of cleanliness." The Lord heard Hezekiah and healed the people. The people of Israel who were present at Jerusalem kept the festival of unleavened bread 7 days with great gladness. And the Levites and the priests praised the Lord day by day, accompanied by loud instruments for the Lord. Hezekiah spoke encouragingly to the Levites, who showed good skill in the service of the Lord. So the people ate the food of the festival for 7 days, sacrificing offerings of well-being and giving thanks to the Lord, the God of the ancestors. Then the whole assembly agreed together to keep the festival of another 7 days, so they kept it for another 7 days with gladness. For King Hezekiah of Judah gave the assembly 1,000 bulls and 7,000 sheep for offering, and the officials gave the assembly 1,000 bulls and 10,000 sheep. The priests sanctified themselves in great numbers. The whole assembly of Judah, the priests and the Levites, and the whole assembly that came out of Israel, and the residents, aliens who came out of the land of Israel, and the resident aliens who lived in Judah rejoiced. There was great joy in Jerusalem, for since the time of Solomon, son of King David of Israel, there had been nothing like this in Jerusalem. Then the priests and the Levites stood up and blessed the people, and their voice was heard. Their prayer came to his holy dwelling in heaven. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Magnificat. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in you, O God, my Savior. For you have looked with favor on your lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. You, the Almighty, have done great things for me, and holy is your name. You have mercy on those who fear you from generation to generation. You have shown strength with your arm, and scattered the proud in their conceit, casting down the mighty from their thrones, and lifting up the lowly. You have filled the hungry with good things, and the rich you have sent away empty. You have come to help of your servant Israel, for you have remembered your promise of mercy, the promise made to our forebears, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The second reading. A reading from the word of the Lord written in Acts chapter 21, verses 1 to 14. When we had parted from them and set sail, we came by a straight course to Kos, and next day to Rhodes, and from there to Patara. We found a ship bound for Phoenicia. We went on board and set sail. We came in sight of Cyprus, and leaving it on our left, we sailed to Syria and landed at Tyre, because the ship was to unload its cargo there. We looked up the disciples and stayed there for 7 days. Through the Spirit, they told David not to go on to Jerusalem. When our days there ended, we left and proceeded on our journey, and all of them with wives and children escorted us outside the city. There we knelt down on the beach and prayed, and said farewell to one another. Then we went on board the ship, and they returned home. When we had finished the voyage from Tyre, we arrived at Ptolemais, and we greeted the brothers and sisters and stayed with them for 1 day. The next day, we left and came to Caesarea, and we went into the house of Philip the evangelist, one of the 7, and stayed with him. He had 4 unmarried daughters who had the gift of prophecy. While they were staying there for several days, a prophet named Agabus came down from Judah. He came to us and took Paul's belt, bound his own feet and hands, and with it, and said, "Thus the Holy Spirit, this is the way the Jews in Jerusalem will bind the man who owns this belt and will hand him over to the Gentiles." When we heard this, we and the people there urged him not to go to Jerusalem. Then Paul answered, "What are you doing, weeping and breaking my heart? For I am ready, not only to be bound, but even to die in Jerusalem for the name of the Lord Jesus." Since he would not be persuaded, he remained silent, except to say, "The Lord's will be done." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the 3rd day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from a time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The Suffrages. Lord, reveal your love among us, that we may know the joy of your salvation. Grant peace within and among all nations, and teach our leaders wisdom. Endow your church with faithfulness, and her servants with knowledge and true godliness. Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed, that your justice may be known among all people. Lord, renew your spirit within us, that in us and through us your will may be done. The collect for today is Proper 21. O God, you declare your almighty power chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Grant us the fullness of your grace, that we, running to obtain your promises, may become partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Prayer of Dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. And also with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.